In today's video, I am going to be breaking down David Kouadio and how he is one of the top middle school prospects in Canada right now. And that is because of his defense. So if you are looking to become a great defender, these are some tips that I'm going to give you that you can use to become a great defender just like David. Let's get down. Let's check out David Kouadio. Okay, so the first thing right here is he's anticipating a pass over towards the wing, and he's able to get there while that pass was in the air. However, if you actually look at where that ball is going and also where he is stealing the ball, there's actually some tips that I can give you, and that is if a team, for one, does a lot of point to wing passes, as we've seen here in this game, you can actually start guessing that they're about to pass to that side, and you can intercept those passes. However, where he's actually intercepting the passes, two-thirds of the way towards that player, two-thirds to three-quarters of the way. That is because that is where you're going to be close enough to that defender to be able to pick off that pass. You want to take out his arms while you're doing so, but also, if you miss the pass, you're still going to be in position to be able to defend him. However, here, David is able to get that steal. He takes three dribbles all the way down court, and he's able to finish with that layup. Three dribbles from the other side of the court. That is a massive, massive tip that I can give you. The fewer amount of dribbles from one side of the court to the other is going to allow you to get there faster, big steps, multiple steps between each dribble, so that you can get these fast break layups. Here's another interception as well. However, this one just goes out of bounds. However, again, we were anticipating that point to wing pass because they did it multiple times back to back to back. You can also start guessing when players are going to pass that ball. And any of these long passes over top of the defense, if you have the ability to jump, of course, this high, that's going to help. However, if you can anticipate these passes and look at how close David was to this player, that is because if this pass was to make it through, David was going to be able to land, pivot, and then jump back up at least to contest that layup. So it's always good to be just a bit risky when it comes to intercepting these passes. And as we can see here, he's missed the interception there. However, he's already in position to be able to get to this man on defense. And that is exactly what we see here. We see a double team in the post. The other team player brings the ball down to his waist, which means that he's out of control according to the referees. David's able to get his hand on that ball and gets that steal. Anytime a player brings that ball down to their waist, you have to get your hand in there to steal that ball. At least with FIBA rules, if the hand is on the basketball, the hand is part of the ball, which means that if you hack their handoff, it doesn't matter because it's part of the ball. So you can get these steals as we see right here. Getting blocks, being able to block that shot and not have it go out of bounds, being able to block it to keep it in bounds, and then looking up court to pass that ball up court after you get that rebound off the block is extremely important. Here we get Ilya intercepting that dribble, and then David was able to come up with that steal. Now watch how many dribbles he takes. Now he fumbles it down court, which is actually a pretty good strategy in itself, but he takes one dribble and then he's able to go for that layup. Look at how many steps he takes though, right? He takes that dribble. That's one step, two steps. He gets that ball. Now it's in his hand, but his hand is on top of the ball. So that's his gather. And then he's able to go up for that layup. No, this is not a travel. And this is how you can really work on the ability to get down court fast. Push that ball ahead, take two steps, gather, you got two more steps, and then you can make that layup. Multiple steps between each dribble is going to be very beneficial to you to be able to go defense to offense. Now, just by pressuring the other team's player just a little bit, as we see right here, can get them to turn the ball over. You don't have to be a fantastic player trying to get your hands in there. You just need to pressure some players enough to a point where they just turn the ball over for you, and then you can take the ball down court. And again, watch, he gets that steal at half, takes one dribble, two dribbles, and look at how many steps he takes between each dribble. This is not a travel. Watch, he takes that dribble, one step, two steps, three steps, takes another dribble, one step, two step, gathers the ball, 1, 2, and then he goes up. Taking multiple steps between each dribble, going from defense to offense, is going to allow you to score more easily in basketball. You can also use your defense to score too. And also watch what he does here on defense. We get that turnover in that low block, and watch what he does. He's anticipating our team, his teammate, Ilya, getting that ball. He's already sprinting down court as fast as he can. Being that amazing outlet man off of defense is going to allow you to score more points, but also your team to win more games, as we see right here with the and one. He wasn't very happy with that call. These tips can help you become a better defender at the middle school level. I hope that this video has helped you become a better basketball player. And of course, definitely go check out Hoop with David, of course, down in the description below to go check out his social media, so that you can keep up with his amazing highlights. Anyways, I hope that you've enjoyed today's video. If you have, hit that like button, subscribe, and I'll see you guys again next time.